me say that again. When you go get with Vital in Brooklyn, don't meet him in all the skeleton for everybody that's out there.
Yeah. And like I said, like every team is based off of the person who lead him. I said that earlier.
Give it up.
Gym in Harlem,
strongest
in New York City, shut down. Every gym in park, every jail, shut down.
Now stop.
هذا حد العالم هذا طالب كان هذا راسخ وإلى آخره
My team, I know everything about them. I will literally stop everything I'm doing to make sure you get back on the same level as me.
Salute that man.
Yeah, man. Yep. That's why everything is beast mode.
Everything, bro.
Yeah.
He's talking about the team. Once again, we're talking about morals. That goes with the bartender's cap.
Yeah.
Character, attitude, personality. He got that.
Yeah.
In thy circle. How many other team members only the leader is shining? Don't nobody else get shine but the leader. Now, you got to big up the person that's underneath you to make them great.
Yeah.
Beast ain't the only one that's great. He made other beasts.
Nice.
I know I'm great because I made other people great that I touched. Whether they with me or not, they came from me. Alright? Now you asked the question earlier. Much respect to my brother Hannibal. Hannibal, for the sake of God, I got love for you. For the sake of the culture, I'm still a little disappointed. Because he could have did a lot, I believe, for the culture. To me, what Hannibal did was just validate a lot of white people that stole a lot of the system.
Yeah.
Anything you want to say positive on that? Not on the negative note, but that's just what I believe.
You got to talk like not places. Not everybody really understands the business side of it. Because from an individual like him who may look at it as it's a come up for me, he don't know the evil intentions they have on that side.
Mm.
So they can throw that's money
deep.
At somebody. They do it in sports. Give
that's
them
deep.
20 million. Have them come over here to validate our because they're going to make all the money at the end of the day. So you can't really fault somebody who really doesn't know. That's how I always like,
that's heavy.
I speak to him all the time.
You know what? I'm going to take that because he speaks to him and I don't.
Yeah.
I just think he's been too many places not to still be aware. But if he's saying he's not aware, Vital ain't never mislead me a lot of me. I'm going to take that. I'm going to respect that.
We always have conversations because that's another reason why I never went over there. And I never, because like I say, like, you never seen a karate picture where the grandmaster will meet people. Don't work like this. I don't care how much money they offer me.
Whoa.
I'm not leaving my temple. You come here. You come here and you want to learn. I'll teach you everything you need to know before I send you back off. But I'm not going to y'all. And that's how I've always been. Yeah, but I don't knock everybody else that did it. I'm just not doing it.
Right. So guess what? Again, like I said, Mama told you earlier, Vital's just not going to rock with me like some people do because I'm giant. He's gonna give his wisdom on it. You just heard his wisdom? I said one thing I believe, that the brother should have been more responsible for our community and our culture. He believes if you're not on the science and wisdom to see that, then you're gonna tread the path you believe is great for you. I humbly accept that. I'll take that.
Yeah.
I'll take that.
Because you gotta remember, once when people got kids, change.
That's all. I got children, a lot of them. But I ain't selling the culture out, man.
But that's
giant,
because you look at it,
you don't know.
You look at it different. Like if he don't think that he's selling the coach out, if he think he's just feeding his kids, it's a whole different
mindset.
Yeah, like his mindset could be totally different.
Yeah, never said nothing. His brother never had nothing.
Yeah,
he came to home. He came to the bartender. He had nothing. I thought I'll feed him.
Yeah,
clothing him and all that.
Yeah,
I make sure the whole team good. Then once he got on, they forgot. Like. Serious? Forgot.
That's coming straight from 2G mouth, bro. He was
then,
there.
Then, not so. Only that, I started the sport. I mean, me made you start the sport. We made teams for the sport to keep it going and all that. I told Major from day one. We do a bartender. It wasn't for bartender. It won't be no sport. So I'm going to do the sport together and see what happens. And see what happens. Now, he came giant. No more Major. He came giant. This mine. Oh, it's yours. Okay. Let me fall back and can do you. I ain't gonna hate. Keep doing you.
Now keep in mind what the brother's saying, that's something called MBXA for those that don't know. You gotta go interview somebody named 240, because 240 in 2000 was there. Big Mike. It was bartenders extreme first, and I was giving it to them. My brother got upset with me and said I'm leaving, and then dropped the extreme, and then put the NB, which is cool. But it was bartenders extreme because they did weights and bar. Then it became, nah, I'm gonna do the NBA. Salute. And then 2G called me, I'm going with the brother. Sound like my dad. Like, go, like he said, go do your thing. Don't stay with me. If you got a light over there, do it. We're doing all competitions. I said, I don't think that's gonna work for long because the people are gonna get tired of seeing competitions. I can't keep coming to see. There gotta be something else going on besides me seeing you do pull-ups.
See, it was just a competition. It was a sport. And people got to try it for the sport. It was just like, it's a sport, but people had different teams and all that. It wasn't for the sport, it being all these different teams, different names and all that. Before, there's one name, they're bartenders, and being streamed. We made it with different teams all over the globe. Now, you two, you see different teams. I got a team. Well, for the sport, don't be only teams. Those are facts. Know what I'm saying? Those are facts.
So, know question. What I mean? How do you feel about the contests? Because it wasn't just one. It was triple Bs. You got it? It's a lot of other stuff. How do you feel about all of the competition that's going on now? Like you said, what's the goal? What's the purpose and benefit? Because yeah. I don't mind going to a competition. But again, while I'm there, what's the goal? What's the purpose? How does it help?
Me coming up, the only competition I really had love and respect for was 5Bs. Because back then, they were the only one doing it. This is when I was still young. And there was a bunch of dudes, like you said, it was dudes that just came home, and everybody was on the bar, so he took all the brothers, brought them to 21 Park, and they did their thing. This is in the 90s. So, and I followed them until they got to Lincoln Terrace. Even though it was the same thing, but it was more about bringing people together every year to do that. It wasn't those tricks, it was strict reps. I think the first freestyle calisthenic is when Matrix did it in the Bronx.
Yeah.
And it was good because it was good to see a lot of other people
coming together. I totally agree.
But then you have to start increasing it or start getting repetitive. It'll start getting repetitive. And then at the end of the day, people are going to be like, where's the money? If I won $1,000 last year, you gotta give me $2,000 this year. It's just natural progress.
You won $1,000 this year, you gotta give me $2,000.
You got to increase.
This is why our bartender, hopefully we're gonna talk our EIB competition. 5 stacks, 10 stacks, and it only costs a G to enter. If it's 9 of y'all on the team, chip in. Cause you tripling your money. If you win that EIB trophy, they're gonna know you're nice. EIB trophy or EIB? EIB, oh, that's different, bro. It's a different challenge of innovative styles and exercise. That's important, man.
Yeah.
That's important.
There's a lot of stuff you can still do out there. It's just putting the plan together.
True.
And execute.
True.
Because for years, everybody just, there's been too much bickering and nobody making money.
But what is the real bickering about on the real? What you think is the real, why we can't all leaders, because I know we're not going to come together, but why can't all the leaders just come stand here and build?
Ego.
Some will.
I can say. Ego? Yeah. Ego.
I think as you know you garbage until you get around real people that's nice, that's nasty.
Yeah, but then that's still.
That is ego.
Yeah, that's ego.
That's ego.
You only as big as the people you step on.
Oh. You only as big as the people you step on.
Yeah. Cause they the ones that gonna look up to you. Me, I'm down here with the people. My reign is good. I'm good where I'm at. I don't need to be there. I'm not in the public eye. I stepped back years ago. I'm like, here we are. Yeah, the people still contact me. I still train. I still get the money residuals if that's what you think I need, but nah.
Yeah. So what can we do to come together? If you can tell anything to the leaders out there, to the teams that we believe have some type of voice in the game, what would you be to say to y'all if we're coming together to do a conversation?
Everybody need to come together and have a real non-biased conversation.
Non-biased.
You know what it is? I tell you what happened.
And don't lie. That's the main
thing. Hold up. That's heavy. Even if you're not who you are, just come as you are.
Yeah.
And what I mean by that is not the image you two gave me, because I see behind that, like B said. Just come as you are. Let's just vibe to see, because no other country's bigger than us.
Yeah.
I don't care how many flips you do on the ball. We're going to talk about that in a minute. Between sets and mixing this with gymnastics. We're going to get in that conversation in a minute.
Yeah.
But you want to elaborate on that?
Yeah, first of all, I see people on UK, Japan, all on YouTube doing competitions. Right? And a lot of guys, they getting plane tickets going to UK, ball masters, all them dudes. They've got one thing. They don't have the science and the ingredients to be us. That's what they're missing. They're missing us. We didn't miss a link for anything on YouTube and all that. I'm 54, still working out, still training, and I was paralyzed at 99.
He grew up on you, man. He grew up on
you. So therefore, you know what I'm saying, all the dudes going to YouTube and all that, they think they're nice and all that. We got one thing. We got about Giant, got about 2000, forgot about them dudes, they forgot.
No, I'm not saying they forgot. They can't bury the truth. Bro.
2020 gonna be a whole different kind of year.
But even if y'all never mention my name in history, keep doing my moves. I'ma point you out.
That's never gonna happen because it's history. Like I said, no matter what I go through, I can never take away what you did for people with those videos.
But that's the level you on to speak that truth.
Yeah, and I never lie.
That's vital.
It doesn't matter. Ask me, I'm gonna tell you.
That's what makes it vital.
Yeah.
You feel me? Why everybody else can't do the same thing? Nah, they was here before me, blah, blah, blah. I was watching these, and then I boom, 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 boom.
Nah, they're not raised like that. You gotta know, like, I was built off different principles. I mean, like, that's why, like, when I get upset by certain things, it's because of how I was raised. Some people, they can get slapped long before nobody see it, they ain't gonna say nothing. Not me. It's a different way people react to certain things. Yeah.
Translation is a lump of flesh, a piece of meat. And when that lump of flesh